Welcome back to our series of little talks about age, aging, healthy life, and maybe living forever, if that's what we are looking for. So far, we have talked about the biological basis of life. How do we live? What things happen? What things go wrong? And if we live long enough, we face this question of old age and lots of problems associated with old age. Maybe that's why we don't want to be treated as an old person or called as an old person, because from the body's point of view, there is very little to look forward to old age with the bodies we have. And last time we also talked that even sociologically, there are so many issues which make you frightened of old age, because everybody considers us in old age as a burden, that you are using society's resources too much. And that leads to your visibility loss. You are not needed by society. You become lonely. Now, as a biologist, I can't do much on that aspect. But as a biologist, we are working hard on developing new approaches on how to maintain health. There is not going to be a magic pill. The way we have discussed about aging, it's so individualistic that no single pill is going to give us permanent solutions. So we will have to develop our own solutions, where science is working hard on that. And our main aim as a scientist working in the field of aging is not to make us live forever, or not just to also concentrate on specific diseases, but how to maintain health. Now, that is a very challenging question. What is health? We all talk about health. Health, but what is health? Health is not just absence of disease. That is not health. Even the WHO's own definition of health is that health is a complete state of physical, mental, and social well-being. Yeah, that is the official definition of WHO. A complete state of physical, mental, and social well-being. The problem with this definition is we don't know what is well-being. It doesn't define what is well-being. Yeah, how do we measure it? Is it what I say I feel happy? Is that enough? Or is there an independent way of measuring health? So as scientists, we have been doing a lot of work, people like me and others, to define health. Can we measure health in some biological way? And in that case, we are using the concept of activities of daily living. Yeah, this is a very well-established clinical concept which all doctors use, that activities of daily living, like can I get up from the bed without any help? Can I change my clothes myself? Can I reach the toilet and take care of my needs there? Can I go for shopping? What grip strength I have? What speed I walk? So there are about 50 to 60 this list of activities of daily living. And that is the concept we use in defining health. So health in that way can be defined as absolute freedom in independence, absolute independence, physical and mental independence in activities of daily life. Yeah? Absolute independence in activities of daily life. Now, this is like WHO definition. It doesn't tell much because nobody has this kind of absolute health. There is no absolute independence in physical and mental activities of daily living because we depend upon on a lot of technology, a lot of lifestyle factors. Just wearing clothes to control my reaction to the body temperature is dependence. So if I use glasses to focus my eyesight, I am having a little bit of dependence. I am not totally independent. So absolute independence, which means absolute health, it does not exist. So don't worry about absolute health. I am never going to be absolutely healthy in this way. That absolute freedom of or independence of physical and mental activities of daily living. Then question comes, then what is then health? Practical definition. Practical definition is adequate independence of physical and mental activities of daily living. Now, this word adequate is very, very important. Adequate means what? When I will be even more older than that, for me, adequate health will perhaps mean that I should be able to get up from my bed and reach the toilet in time. Yeah, that will be adequate. I don't want to be adequate to go out and play with Rafael Nadal or Caroline Wozniacki. I don't want to compete for that. So adequate changes with age. At one age, what is adequate is different at another age. It's something similar with even material goods, with money. How much money is adequate? I can have everything and be still miserable because I don't have the same money like Facebook owner or the Google people. Yeah. Adequate is a lot of psychological factor in it. What makes you satisfied with your own life? At what stage and in what way we will handle? Third part of that is quality of life. Quality of life is personal. You can show me hundreds of things going wrong in my body and mind and everything, and I might still be happy. Yeah? Or you can show me that I have perfect health in every blood measurement, every gene measurement, I can still be miserable. Yeah, those are more psychological. But in this adequate health, how can science help us to maintain adequate health? By using technology, by using medicine, by using lifestyle things which you are learning in other parts of the course. All these things are towards maintaining health. And what are those approaches? This is what we will be following in our next parts of the series. See you next time.